Have you decided on anything, Mrs. Carrington?
Yes, I think I'll take the mink. And I'll take the full-length fox and the sable and the three jackets, the chinchilla, the lynx, and the ermine.
That's three coats and three jackets?
I believe that's what I said, yes.
Along with the chinchilla muff and the two Persian lamb ski hats?
Are you in the business of counting or are you in the business of selling? Has Blake Carrington been in here talking to you about me?
Why, no, of course not.
Have any of the other members of the Carringtons been in here? Is that why you're so uninterested in selling to me?
Mrs. Carrington, I think you've misunderstood. I didn't mean anything like that.
I know exactly what you meant. I'm not a fool. And I'm very good at sensing hostility where I find it.
I'm sorry.
I think we both got a little out of hand. I'm glad we understand each other. Just send the bill to my husband, Adam Carrington.
Heard about your little shopping spree today. Why should I pay for all this?
Because technically we're still married. And because I had to put up with you and all of your lies. So you owe me.
Oh, Claudia. Is this how it is with you? Going from one of us to the other? Staying with whoever is stupid enough to pay your bills?
Not anymore. I'm finished with all of the Carringtons now that I have my will.
I wouldn't count on me off my profits if I were you.
Don't you threaten me, Adam. You can't take it back. I still have a weapon over you.
Take it? I wouldn't take it as a present. And in case you haven't checked your production yet, your well is drying up. Much like this conversation.
Yes, let me speak to Blake Carrington. No. When he gets back to town, it'll be soon enough.